Okay. Did you see how he was anticipating it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. My gosh. This is one of the ways you can get more attention and really, I want to stop saying shit, and I want to figure out the game.
I've been trying to do that. I'm going off for a walk, it's all crazy. I want to sit.
Raz, sit. Okay. Good. Let's try that again. All right, this is not hard. Raz. Okay. The other dog comes in. Hang on, we're almost ready, Tina. He's a terrier. He'll pick us up instantly.
Yeah.
It's not because he's not smart. It's because he's too focused on success and food. So it's getting in the way. Very bright.
Session. That would be my full session.
So I lured and stopped and lured and stopped. Look, he knows how to sit. I want him to be able to lure. And so now I'm going to feed him. I will never lure him into a sit again from this moment on. And it's fine and dandy that he does it if you say sit, but I want him to start offering it for every emotional thing that he wants. So that when he says, oh, there's food in the corner, his first thought isn't drag me over, I can just get it. His first thought is, look, Mom, I'm looking at you, please, look what I want. Mom, what I want. So I want more attention. And I'll do this in my house. I'll do it anywhere. He clearly has great food drive. He was in a high annoying state of arousal to the other dog. And then in a very high state of arousal, turned around and said, oh, lamb lung, I can work. Yeah, that's work. So his best qualities are also his worst qualities, and that is often the case. Did you hear him get demanded? Good. Now, I'm going to walk him around because I don't want him to offer a sit while I'm talking to you. We are about to undergo the very most important part, second most important part of training with food. First most important part was I lure, he offers a behavior, I never freaking lure that behavior again. This is now the second part.
Nice.
Oh, okay. Here's the second part. Yes, good boy! Oh my God, good boy. I didn't have any food on me. That was the first time I didn't have food on me. He said, yes, oh, good boy. Oh my God. So I'm sorry, I'm feeding him a tremendous amount. Hopefully he'll purge in the car. So now I'm like, really obviously don't have food. Smart dog. Yes, boy. That's a temper tantrum. It's not a foot pop. Boy. So it's really important. Yes, good boy. What usually happens is the first time you do the behavior and you don't have food, you pet the dog on the head and you say that was great, and the dog says, I get it. You have food. I get it. You don't have food, I don't get food. Therefore, if I don't think you have food, I will not do the behavior. And you are in for a lifetime of having to show him that you have food and get him to do it. And you don't want that. That's a big complaint about using food. You'll only do it if you have food. And then in an early training session, have this big obvious cue that we're using food. I like to have it in different pockets in front of my back pocket. Now, I want to teach him some more impulse control and some attention. So this is how I teach him to stay. Now I'm changing the rules. Oh, you have done a great job with this dog. So he knew immediately what I wanted, right? I didn't want to step back and says, oh, we're doing this today. Boy. So I changed the rules, and I've said now, the only thing that will get me to go there is you staying in the sit. And so, you know, he says, well, to hell with you. I prefer it the other way, where you were my little servant. I can't have that scrap. And again, remember I said yesterday, I want to have the best, biggest, and give the most food. Because if I don't want my dog to think that what's on the floor is better than what I have. And he's already pondering that. smart dog does this kind of thinking.
What could that mean?
Is there a specific reason for the double leash?
I put a double leash on when I was testing him with the other dog. I would never, ever put just one leash unless it was my own. He heard me talking, and he saw that I was looking up, and he took a dive for the food. This is the dog that barks when you're on the floor.
Yeah.
I mean, he might not, but this is, but again, I'm just pointing out what he's doing. This is why people always think, oh, well, we want a smart dog. You don't want a smart dog. It's so much easier when it's not a dog. This is a smart dog.
Yeah.
They're all equally trainable. It's just the dumb dog doesn't figure things out, not as cunning. You don't want Lemlin anymore? This is the other reason I have three different levels of treats. Because I gave him, he's a small dog, I gave him a hideous amount. And he's like, you know, he said, that was really great. I'm a little boring right now. She said, gotta move for it. I'm a little more full. And so I would have loved to now put a piece of string cheese right there, a whole finger of string cheese.
That's something pretty good.
You do? Just put it right on that, make a big production, put it right down there. Good, big flip. Wow, look what I'm putting here.
Wow, look at this.
Great, good. Good, now I'm starting to get attention where I didn't have it there. So already he's like, might these things have something to do with you? And then, good boy. So now, when I start out, because we had such a dry spell, I went back to just, if you sit, I'll go get that. Now he says, oh, fantastic.